we have a very able accountant, I would say accountant, who is going to talk to us on this subject, is C.A. Chintan Patel. I thank you very much, Chintan, for coming from Ahmedabad all the way just to address us. And it's very nice of you on a Saturday morning to fly in and just spare some time for us. He is not only a qualified chartered accountant, he is not only a teacher in the sense he teaches IFRS to we chartered accountants. He is an expert in, the implementation of so many, accounting standards. He is also a DIRM to deal with the insurance and risk management. He is also a medalist, I think. I believe he's the first rank holder in our CA Institute conducted DIRM examination. He is not only DISA, he is also CISA. He is also a company secretary in his own right, apart from being a successful chartered accountant that he is. And certainly he is himself an IFRS professional himself. And, he is, the one resource person for IFRS, certificate courses that the Institute conducts. And he's always available. He's convener of so many committees, including the, IFRS committees. He is also, the member of the FRRB group. He's a technical reviewer for the Corporate Excellence Award that the Institute has instituted. He is, not only good in academics, but he is available to the Institute as and when we need it. When we need him for some talks, some subjects, some work groups, some, discussions, he's always available. And therefore, we also find his articles in so many, our journals and newsletters. He is, available for training, not only in the Institute, but in corporates like ONGC and with the, those responsible even at our helm auditor, the CAG, the Comptroller Auditor General. He takes training classes even in some other big corporates. The list is very long, believe me. And I don't want to eat much on the time that is allocated to him. But I will only say that he has a very good hand on the experience of international gap conversion. He is also good at XBRL convergence. He is also good in advising companies, particularly the foreign businesses, to set up business in India. The list is very long. I'm sorry, I have to cut it here. Sir, before I request you to take on, I would request the Dean of Wellington Institute of Management, C.A. Kanubai Joshi, to come and, welcome our next speaker with a memento. And, we all request you to carry with applause. The floor is yours, accounting on management by C.A. Chintan Patel. C.A. Chintan Patel, please. Thank you.
Thank you. In India, it has been varied. because the reason is the sector is also a different sector. Before going to the accounting for agriculture, first I would like to congratulate WRC, CMIA for arranging this workshop. The reason is that for the first time I have heard someone has kept a full day workshop on agriculture specifically. So congratulations to WRC and CMIA for that. Now, first my flow presentation is that first I will talk about accounting of agriculture in India. Then I will discuss more on international perspective of accounting of agriculture. Now let's talk about accounting of agriculture in India. What we are doing for accounting of agriculture in India? Any idea on this? Any thought on this? How we are doing accounting of agriculture in India? Any views on this subject?
Just like other business.
Just like other business, right? Fantastic. Any other view? So do you feel that there has to be a separate standard on agriculture, or what we are doing for other businesses is okay for accounting agriculture? Do you think it's required?
Yes.
Okay, yes. Why?
Seasonal.
Because it's perishable nature, then?
It's the main occupation of India.
It's the main occupation of India. Oh, because we can say there are a lot of people who are working in this agriculture sector. So obviously there has to be a specific interest, specific concern for agriculture accounting. Anything other than that?
Valuation.
Valuation, which is very tricky aspect for agriculture. Can you sir give more idea on valuation? How valuation is a tricky for agriculture? As far as standing crops are concerned, how can we value the crops we are standing? One. Second thing is that, for example, if I am the dairy business and cattle, so there is a cattle which is being born, newborn cattle. How do value newborn cattle for that? Well, the valuation of company is based on these all aspects. I'm sure that you are very much expert about agriculture sector per se, but we can discuss more on how to accounting of the agriculture activity. So, what I got from you is that there is not a single specific standard on agriculture.
But IFRS, I believe they are going to.
Absolutely right. In IFRS, there is a specific standard which is IAS 41, which talks about accounting for agriculture. So we'll discuss on IAS 41 later on. Once we are through with the Indian perspective on accounting. When there is not a specific standard, so how it is governed? It's governed through different other accounting standards which are prevalent in India, right? Which standard we can discuss in India if you are talking about accounting of agriculture in India? AS 10, which is on fixed asset accounting. I know there are certain people who are not having a CA background, but still I will just discuss more on accounting standards per se. AS 10, accounting for fixed assets, which says that in the scope para, it says that it excludes accounting for livestock, accounting for plantation, forest product, etc. So the AS10 start with the scope, and scope exclude agriculture accounting. Then another standard, AS6, which is on depreciation accounting. In AS6, again in start there is objective scope. Scope says it excludes livestock, forest product, then what is the other standard? AS2 inventory. Now AS2 inventory again says that it starts only when the agriculture produce is harvested. So once I harvest agriculture produce, then only AS2 starts. Now what I do? When I go to AS10, it says no, get out. When I go to AS6, no, get out. AS2 come only after agriculture produce is ready. Then where I shall go? Where shall I go for accounting of agriculture? Where? She is jumping over to IFRS India's 41. Yes, India's 41 is something from where we can get some references. But when we talk about Indian accounting, sorry, in Indian accounting, how can we do references of accounting of agriculture? For which standard? Okay, AS9, which is on revenue recognition. Now AS9 revenue recognition applies for revenue accounting. For when I sell the agriculture produce, the, for accounting of sale, ASNI is available. But what about the cost I'm incurring every day and day out for agriculture activity? So we have to go to our base. Accounting standards are based on framework. Now framework of accounting standards define what is asset, what is liability, what is income, what is expenses. Now what is asset as per framework? Asset is a resource controlled by an entity as a result of past events from which future economic benefits are expected to flow to the entity. So once, if I want to capitalize particular item as an asset, I just need to see that is it an asset as per IFRS framework, as per framework of ICI? If yes, it is asset. If no, then it is expense. Now what is liability? Anybody is having definition of liability?
Potential obligation of
a debt. Obligation word is right. It's a present obligation. Again, present obligation as a result of past events from which the settlement of which is expected to arise. Outflow of economic resources from the company. So when you talk about asset, it's a resource controlled by an entity. The most important word is control. I must control a resource. And from which activity is expected to put to the entity. When I talk about the liability, there has to be a present obligation. Then only I can talk about the liability section. So when we talk about accounting of agriculture in India, there is not a specific standard which talks about accounting of agriculture. We have to go through the framework and then we can take references from AS10, AS6 and AS2. Scope out the requirement of agriculture specifically. Old Schedule 6 was governing about these provisions. AS2 inventories of livestock, agriculture and forest product is start only after the agriculture produce is harvested. AS9 revenue recognition, as the gentleman was talking about revenue recognition, AS9 is applicable only for the purpose of revenue recognition. Now let's take a case where in certain cases government provides a minimum guarantee price. Right? In that case, how do we account for revenue? Though in certain cases we find that government says that if you produce this particular weight of this ton, we assure that you get at least 5 rupees per metric ton, whatever per MT. Now, when you talk about revenue recognition standard, revenue can be recognized wherever significant risk and reward is transferred. So it may be a possible situation to talk about that when the government has given a minimum guarantee price and guarantee purchase of the particular item, then what is the point of recognition of revenue? I will say the point of recognition of revenue is the same point when the agriculture produce is ready for the sale. So even if I have not sold to customer, I can recognize revenue immediately when the agriculture produce is ready or is produced. Because wherever there is a minimum guarantees given by the government and it is assured that significant risk and reward is transferred, we can recognize revenue immediately on agricultural produce. Now we are coming to IS 41 agriculture. We are discussing about Indian practice. In India, there is not a specific standard, so we have to go to IFRS framework, we go to framework of standard, then we go to different standards to arrive at accounting of agriculture. So ultimately, what we are doing? Ultimately, we are following historical cost model. Because in India, the main is historical cost is my basic principle. So we are applying historical cost model for agriculture accounting in India. When we talk about IS 41 or Ind AS 41, which is going to come to India, it talks about the fair value concept. Now, do you feel that historical cost is appropriate or fair value is appropriate? Which one is appropriate? Fair value? Anyone is historical cost? No? All say fair value. You are saying historical cost. Why?
It is the incurred cost. That is the
actual cost which is incurred by the company, so historical cost is the right approach. Fine. Why are you saying fair value?
Based on the market, how much they are actually obtained by selling the product.
Fine. Okay, now what he is saying is that if I just think from Indian perspective, history of cost is something which is very easily identifiable, which is very easily measurable. So definitely it's easy to do accounting with the history of cost. But when you're talking about investors or stakeholders analysis point of view, which may not be a right approach, the reason is that when I purchase particular cattle, I paid X amount. But during the period, during the year, there may be addition, growth, or there is a reduction, or there is some new born of animal. So all these factors are not computed or calculated in the historical point. So the IFRS says that we should go by fair value approach. The reason is that historical cost approach is not able to provide exact financial result of the company. And the three conditions are fulfilled. One is the entity controls the asset as a result of past events. So control has to be there. Second, what is control? Again, let us talk about control. What is control? What is control? How can you demonstrate control?
Most of the benefit that can be derived
from the asset. So you are saying owning is the most important thing for control? Yes. Only, yes, it's an important thing, but is it the only thing for control?
Risk
and rewards, okay, fine.
Can I say that
I am controlling this hall because risk and reward is there if they are paying me?
Yes, you are controlling the hall now.
So can I say can I recognize asset for 2 hours and then I can depreciate over 2 hours? So what is the missing element for control and for the what is the missing element for recognition in
ownership?
Ownership is not only answer. Also ownership is ownership something which legal documentation can see. But if you look at substance over form.
Capacity to bring in alterations.
Capability
in alterations like modification
change. I can alternate my slides. But that is not enough, right?
Right to exploit.
Exploit what? Exploit audience. I have influence over all of that. I have decision power how I want to take my resolution. So you all agree that this hall is good like me. Sir, WRC is going to lose this hall for 2 hours.
You can't destroy this one.
Destroy?
My God.
You can't have that much control.
So for explaining a definition of control, she is giving me okay, you don't have control. Obviously.
We don't transfer the right to own to other person.
I can transfer right to speech to Joshi sir for 1 hour. What is missing is a right to restrict anybody to entry. I can't say anybody, you can't come to hall. So control is demonstrated by right to restrict anybody from entering premises. So that is where it's missing. So three things. One thing is that the entity controls the asset as a result of past event. Two, it is probable that the future economic benefits associated with the entity will flow to the entity. And third, fair value or cost of the asset can be measured reliably. If these three conditions are fulfilled, then can I recognize the biological asset in the observer? Measurement at fair value as cost to sale. So measurement of biological asset or agricultural produce at the point of harvest is only one, that is fair value less cost to sale. Biological asset at initial recognition and at that of each reporting period for agricultural produce at the point of harvest. Gain or loss on change in fair value as cost to sale will go to profit loss account. So change in fair value cost to sale of biological asset or anything else will go to P&L account. Now one question is that can there be a case of initial recognition of loss at the time of initial recognition of biological asset? For example, can I record loss at the same time of initial recognition of biological asset? For example, I have purchased a cattle which is at fair value, at market value, and at the same time Can I record a loss? The same point of time?
Is the weight of the asset in reduced?
Same time. I purchase, I know this is a cattle, weight is perfectly fine, healthy. I'm paying a price for whatever the health the cattle is having. Can I afford a same at the same time loss also?
Yes.
How?
Because probably your selling rate can be
okay, fine. See, because when I purchase right now, I expect that selling rate will be same at least at the same time. Obviously, that's if it is market, even if real price is there, the same time the price has to be same.
You might have discovered some disease or something in the
okay. Which is subsequent to the sale, which is subsequent to purchase.
One example could be you buy a pregnant cow and instead of cow again, it delivered a bullet.
Okay, but that is again.
That is a loss.
Absolutely. See, now what she is saying is right, but there is subsequent reason.
Yes.
I am saying, see, when initially when I purchase at the same time, I say it's cow, which is pregnant, I record a particular amount. Subsequently, I come to know it is something wrong, so there is a loss. But it is not initial loss. My patient was initial loss at the same point of transaction. Because the measurement principle says the fair value that cost to sell. Right? So when I purchase, it was a fair value. But does not cost of to sale was reduced from that. So if there is estimated cost of sales involved with the particular animal, then it is an initial recognition of loss at the time of purchase of animal itself. Let's have an example of that.
But I think it would take where if the intention is to sell, if the intention to as a hold that animal, then I don't think then it can be a loss.
Okay, now he is talking about the intention. This is more relevant for investment point of view. Here the measurement sales says that you have to value at fair value less cost to sell. So even if my intention is not to sell it, but still valueless cost to sell measurement covers the estimated cost of disposal.
Or doesn't mean that you are trading that business, you don't have agriculture business.
No, but sir, here what happens, when we apply fair value, it doesn't mean that my intention is to sell. When we apply fair value, my intention is, even if the intention is to use, but I just want to give a true picture of my financials, that's why the approach of measurement is FPLCDS.
Does it mean that even for an individual doing agriculture as his business, for his livelihood, every year his value of livestock in his own balance sheet could change according to the values?
Okay, now that's really a very good question. This is the reason why there is no Santa in India. You raised question, you also answered the question that why there is no Santa in India. Because in India, agriculture activity is so scattered. For any individual person, it's not possible. Even they are, what Joshiji was saying, that there are certain cases where they are meeting with single entry system. There is not a single double entry system. They are just doing economy as a single entry system. Now we have to go from single to double to historical cost, full phase, and then historical cost to go fair value. So it's a long way where we have to approach this level. So I feel when the India's podium will come, obviously it will apply only to certain industry and in certain level of companies. Standard doesn't allow you to take a clue that in subsequent measurement I am unable to measure my biological assets. For subsequent measurement, standard assumes that each and every entity is able to measure at an appropriate SPS. So you can measure at cost only for initial measurement of biological assets. Yes, madam, you have a question. Okay, now see, these all factors are considered for valuation purpose. Valuation is possible, but yes, there is some possibility of reduction in value because of the government, plantation is not being allowed to be sold by government. So valuation will factor into that these reasons of not able to sell. So valuation is definitely possible. Valuation is possible, that means you have to apply at FPLCDS. Then the cost to sell is zero. Yeah. Fair value is available. Cost to sell is zero. So that means fair value minus cost to sell is your FPSPS. income under IS 41 is classified into three portions. One is initial loss or gain on value to assets. Two, change in fair value less cost to sale of value to asset. And third is initial gain or loss on agricultural holding. Now I think this is very much clear to everybody. For biological assets, measurement is at two stages. One is initial measurement at the time of recognition, and two is subsequent measurement at each and every reporting date. For harvest or for agricultural produce, it is at the point of harvest you do measure at fair value less cost to sale. If the cost to sale is zero, you do measure at fair value. Now the question is it revenue? The change in fair value cost to sale or fair value cost to sale, the amount is going to profit loss account. Can I say it is revenue? If there is some, if there is additional surplus because of the change in fair value cost to sale, can I say it is revenue? No. Why?
It is conservative approach. It is a basic approach of the accounting. Because you have to
edit
the profitable loss, not the profit.
Okay, now this is a question about recording P&L account. P&L account has to be recorded. Your profit or income has to be recorded. So conservative approach is not applicable here. Because you are recording in your P&L account. My question is that when you are recording profit, because of change in FPSPS, whether the profit is a revenue or not. Now for revenue, it is not a revenue. The reason is that for revenue to be termed, it has to be arised from ordinary activity of the company, which is not from a change in actual experience. So it is an income, which, but it is not a revenue, which is a part of profit loss account.
But then you are crediting it to profit and loss account, so?
Yes. See, that's a, in profit loss account, there are two things. One is revenue, second is income. When we talk about revenue, it's a top line. So it is not revenue, but it is other income. These are the stages of accounting life of biological assets. First, there is acquisition of biological assets, then there is development cost, then there is harvest and initial acquisition of agricultural produce, and last is additional cost to complete the production process. Acquisition of biological assets is something which is very easy. Generally, it is determined at a cost, and harvest cost to sale is being applied. Now, for development of cost, now what Madam has asked question earlier about. For plantation activity, there will be so many costs incurred subsequent to that. How to measure this particular cost? So development cost, we have to go by again the definition of asset and expenses. Is it a resource controlled by an entity as a result of past event? If answer is yes, it is asset, you can capitalize. If it is no, expense off. But whatever you do, whether you capitalize or expense off, final result in the account is going to be the same because you apply fair value concept. Government grants. Now we are just last two slides, so then I will not come in between your lunch time. Government grants. Under IS 20, which talks about accounting for government grant, the scope excludes accounting of agriculture related to government grant. So for government grant, we are coming back to IS 41. IS 41 says that if the government grant is unconditional, you can record a government grant as an income when it's receivable. If it is conditional, then you recognize as income wherever the conditions are being satisfied. That is insert. So it's conditional, recognize when conditions are satisfied. If it's unconditional, recognize when it's received. Disclosure, there are a lot of disclosures involved under IS 41 and Ind AS 41. It talks about mainly two things. One thing is that disclosure of gain or loss on change in fair value cost to sale, and two, of description of each group of biological assets. Now, group of biological assets can be classified into two portions. One is a bearer agricultural asset, and second is a consumable agricultural asset. Now, bearer agricultural assets are something which is forming part of the my biological assets, from which agricultural produce is coming into picture. And consumable is something like wheat is consumable. So the crops which are bearer, from which the cotton is coming out to picture, that crops is my bearer agricultural land, which I'm going to use next year also. So the disclosure requires classification of biological asset into two portions. One is a bearer agriculture land, and second is a consumable agriculture asset. Now we talk about difference between IS-41 and IND-41. We talk about first accounting of agriculture in India, then we talk about accounting of agriculture under IFRS, that is IS-41, and third last point is IND-41 and IS-41 difference. And then IND-41, which is proposed standard, which will be applicable to India when IFRS is adopted in India. The main difference is that barrel agriculture lands or barrel agriculture plants scored out of Ind AS 41 and to be covered under Ind AS 16. So if you talk about barrel agriculture plants, agriculture accounting is not applicable as far as Ind AS 41 is applicable. That means if I am doing a production of like tea leaves, like from leaf, so that leaf and plant is my barrel agriculture plant. So every year from that plant I am going to have production of this tea. So which is out of the scope of Ind AS 41. If we talk about cotton, which is harvested from the crop or plant, that will be plant or crop is my barrel agriculture land, my barrel agriculture plant, because it is going to be used every year, and then every year I will harvest from that cotton. So barrel agriculture plants are scope out from Ind AS 41, and then it is covered under Ind AS 16. Thank you much everybody for that, and if you have any questions on this, I will definitely take it into consideration. Benefit. Benefit may be there or may not be there. So it has to be expensive.